I love how you're all struggling with that, by the way.
We're such a positive crowd. We're like, I'm just happy to be here. So what I want you to do, I'm going to say the line and I want you to give me the response back, okay? I could quite possibly be the biggest Joe and Caspar fan in this room right now. No! Don't worry about the "you suck" bit. That was, I don't know why I added that, but that came in at the perfect time. You suck! Awesome. So, cheering, yeah? The other thing is, there are going to be throughout this two things you need to know. HitTheRoadUSA.com and hashtag HitTheRoadUSA. I will announce those things, yeah? But I need you to cheer. Throughout this, you're going to get an opportunity to say that out loud, yeah? So let's practice it. It's HitTheRoadUSA.com. 1, 2, 3.
HitTheRoadUSA.com.
Perfect. And now we're going to do hashtag HitTheRoadUSA. 1, 2, 3.
Hashtag HitTheRoadUSA.
Oh, what a lovely audience.
Good, perfect. So, there are also other opportunities. Tracy, did you want to speak about some stage
stuff? All right,
guys.
Hello and welcome to YouTube LA. We are live right now for the Joe and Caspar Hit the Road USA Rap Party! Oh yes! Of course, a big hello to our studio audience. Welcome, lovelies. And a big welcome to you guys live streaming right now, beaming in from wherever you are in the world. I have no idea. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I'm not sure. My name is Kayne Tremills. I'm an Aussie TV host, and I was fortunate enough to spend some time in October last year when Joe and Caspar launched their first road trip DVD. I spent some time with them. We got along. I mean, a claim to fame. I got their first taste of Tim Tam Slammers, of Vegemite. I'm sure you've heard of Vegemite. It's like peanut butter, but black and yeasty. I also maybe am responsible for putting them in koala onesies, but that's another story in itself. Anyway, why am I here? Because I'm quite possibly the biggest Joe and Caspar fan in this room right now. Oh, okay, really? I thought you'd react like that, which is why I've devised a test to see where your fandom levels are actually at here in this room. I believe I'm the biggest fan. Maybe I'm not. Hands up if you've got yourself a Joe and Caspar paddle right now. Looks a little like this. Let's see them. I'm going to ask a series of questions that only the most hardcore Joe and Caspar fans will know the answer to. I will ask the question. If it's Joe, put the face up. If it's Caspar, put the face up. Pretty self-explanatory. All right, let's see how this test goes. The first warm-up, hardcore question. Which one is Joe Sugg? No, not the other one, All right, at least 98% of you are right. I can't believe we had a few wrongsters. All right, here's where the hardcore questions get real. Are you ready? Who always wears a red and yellow cap? Oh, there's some consideration. All right, the majority say it is in fact Joe Sugg. Well done. Next question. Who absolutely loves pizza? Oh, it's a no-brainer, that one. Yep, it is in fact Caspar Lee. Well done. Not bad. All right, next question. This is a tricky one. Who has two middle names? Who has two middle names? It is in fact Caspar Lee. Oh, there's some confusion in the ranks. All right. Here's another one. Here's a doozy. Who has a sister that also does YouTube? Only a couple of you got it right. Is it? It is, in fact, Joe and Caspar. Oh, dear. I might have to get security to move all the unhardcore fans. I'm kidding. You can stay. Last one. Who owns a pair of British beef briefs or underwear? British beef underwear. Straight up. That's almost too keen. You know exactly what he's wearing. It is, in fact, Joe Sugg. Well done, team. Well done. All right, that was an interesting test, You know what? I'm going to let security know. No, it's all right. These guys can stay. You are, in fact, hardcore fans. You can stay. Now, for everyone watching right now, live streaming, get ready, strap yourselves in, set your eyes to stun and your ear holes to listen mode, because we have some big global announcements involving Joe and Caspar. They are massive. You do not want to leave your seat or wherever you are right now. Maybe it's the floor or bed. Another thing, we have never ever seen before footage of the Joe and Caspar Hit the Road USA show, so exclusive that not even the boys have seen it. That's how exclusive it is. I love it. Not sure about that. Now, guys, as soon as Joe and Caspar come through those big doors, the road trip is over and the rap party begins. So I want you guys to make them feel as comfortable and feeling good as possible. So let's practice it now. Can I get a hell yeah for Joe and Caspar?
All right. Speaking of which, I have no idea. I have no idea where the boys are, to be honest. Maybe they're stuck in LA traffic. I'm probably supposed to stall at this point. So, oh, you know what? Actually, let's take a look at a clip of the boys that set the trip off. How about that?
Hey, buddy.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm not too bad. How are you?
I'm good, man. I'm just in America right now.
Oh, don't tell me you're going to prank me again.
No.
Don't you dare tell me that you're not coming home.
I'd never do that to you, Joe.
I tell you something. You need to make your bed. Look at the state of your bed. It's an absolute mess.
It's not
bad. No, I'm not talking to you unless you make your bed. Go and make your bed. Go.
Okay, daddy, dad.
Vamos. Vamos? Is that the right word? That's not how you make your bed, Caspar.
I don't have time for that. I actually need to talk to you about something.
Oh, no. What have I done?
It's only like... How many days until we're shooting Hit the Road USA?
Like 15. No, wait, how many?
That's exactly the problem. We need to be a little bit more, like, we're not prepared enough.
I know. Have you got sun cream?
I've been thinking about sun cream.
What do we need for America?
I was thinking inflatable banana. Could you get one from Tesco?
If all the things we could use that's actually, like, practical for our trip, you choose a blow-up inflatable banana. I got a feeling it's going to be just like the first one, Caspar. I don't know if I can handle it.
The last one was a great success, and we're ready to rumble.
And this time we're in control, though. We're in complete control. You're not driving, though, are you? Why are you pausing? Not driving, are you?
That's the thing. I've already learned how to drive for this trip, so... Don't cry.
I don't think I can do this.
Yeah, you can.
I'm gonna be in the cameraman's car behind. We have to get a Joe Sugg stunt double, body double. We need to get someone with a woman's body who can fill in to be my stunt double for any car shot where you're driving. So I'm not getting a car with you again, Caspar.
You don't look like a woman anymore, Joe. You're looking very bulky.
No, I haven't. I've been to the gym like twice.
Look at that. Put it next to your head. It looks way big. Look at that.
Yeah, but look, I'm pushing it. It's an illusion. I'm pushing it up.
I see that. And it's also the angle I'm looking at it from.
Yeah, look at that. Popeye, sit tight. Don't leave your room until I get to America, because I know what you're like. We'll end up losing you before we even start shooting. So stay where you are. Keep ordering room service, okay? And don't leave.
I'll be here.
Okay, I'll be there in a few days, okay? See you soon.
15 seconds.
See you later, mate. Take care. See you later, buddy. Take care. Bye.
And there you go. Apparently, Caspar actually got his way. I'm pretty sure we actually have an inflatable banana around here somewhere. I don't know. There it is. I don't know what you need with an inflatable banana on a road trip. But how about, I just had an idea. What if I get this signed, hand signed personally by the boys, and then we throw it into the audience after this. Interesting. I thought you would be. Now, for those of you live streaming at home, and of course in the audience, we have a social responsibility to use our social media. So we encourage that you tweet your faces off today using the hashtag #HitTheRoadUSA. Okay, and that goes for you guys as well. And for you at home, send in some questions and I will try to ask as many as I possibly can personally up on stage. What's that? I'm getting word. Unless that's the pizza I ordered, it's Joe and Caspar! They have arrived! Oh, yes!
P for park.
What?
P for park.
No, that's reverse.
Dude, sorry, hold on.
That's R for reverse. That's D for drive. Well, no, well done. Yep, stop. That's it, reverse a little bit. Stop. Now P for park. That's neutral. You've got it. And that's the horn. Well done. Right. Woo! I'll leave the key there. Yeah. Let's get out and start this show.
I can't get out. Oh.
That's a button, isn't it?
Oh, my back. Hello.
Oh, here.
Hey.
Hey. We made it.
We made it.
Should we?
We made it.
Let's start the show.
Okay. Hey. Woo! Right. Joe, you did it.
I'm so embarrassed we're late.
Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome Joe and Caspar Lee! Welcome, boys. Welcome, welcome.
Hello,
good to
hello.
See you. Come on in. Oh, here they are. Looking good, don't you think?
Oh, stop.
They were a little
stop
unsure.
It.
Boys, fashionably late to your own rap party, hey?
It's because Caspar can now drive.
Oh, yeah, drive.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice wheels, by the way. That's a far cry from old Katie the camper van.
Oh, I know. Very different.
Hey,
oh,
boys.
My God, there it is.
Yeah,
throwback.
Katie the camper van. Oh. Hey, congratulations. That's the end of the road trip for USA, boys.
We finished it.
Well
we survived.
Done.
Thank you.
First things first, where have you been? Where have you been for the last 2 weeks?
We started off in Mississippi.
Mississippi.
You nailed it. Where did we go after that? We went to New Orleans.
New Orleans.
It's coming.
Hold on. Houston. Then we went to Arizona.
Oh.
And then here.
And
now
then LA.
Right here. Wow, yeah. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Boys have made it. Now, I also saw you guys brought some friends in. Who are they? You brought some friends in. They followed you in. Who were they?
Now we're in America, we have to bring cheerleaders wherever we go to give us.
Apparently, you just need cheerleaders wherever you go.
We were allowed one diva command, and that was we want cheerleaders at all times.
It gives you more cheer and makes you happy.
Yeah.
Sometimes just smiling increases your happiness levels. So they
make
that's
nice. Oh, advice from Caspar. He started off on a soft note. Hey, here's an all important question for those of you live streaming right now and in the audience. Who wants your hands on the next DVD, Hit the Road USA?
Woo.
I thought you might say that, so I've got to tell you that we are here specifically. It's a big, big challenge for us to break the record for pre-sales. You can right now head to hittheroadusa.com right now and pre-order your copy of the DVD. In fact, you boys have teamed up with Amazon. You've got a couple of opportunities this year to break that record. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I was surprised. Like, you're so well trained.
Yeah,
you knew it.
We spent some time together before this, don't you worry. Yeah. So, for those of you at home, one more time, head to pre-order your USA DVD. Boys, you've also got some opportunities, some offers to break the record this year. But some jelly bands and a chance to. Name in the credits?
Yeah, we have. Same again as last year. The first 15,000 people that pre-order get their name in the credits. As long as they don't do one of those like names where they, you know, like Hugh Janus. Like that. There was a few of those last
did they
year.
Really?
There was a few. They had to go through and take them out.
And then I remember last year it sold out in like an hour. So
yeah, so you guys,
if you want that, just try and get it.
I think we can break the record this year. What do you guys think? In an hour? Let's do that. Let's definitely do that. It is available on iTunes worldwide and is also available on Google Play. I've just had a bit of an idea. You guys brought in some cheerleaders and a choir, is that right?
Yes, we did.
Okay. Is it possible to get the choir up here? Can we get the choir up here on stage? Please welcome Joe and Caspar's choir.
Hey! I can't believe we have a choir.
Yeah, no, we do not mess around.
I just had a bit of a thought. So in order to help pre-sales, a little bit of entertainment, I'm wondering if maybe you guys could like sing a tune, like sing Hit the Road USA.com. Oh, yeah? Of course, you're a choir. You're ready to sing at any moment. All right, let's try this. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, and off we go.
Go to Hit the Road USA.
So good.
I'll set the challenge. Every time you hear me say hittheroadusa.com, you have to sing it. How does that sound?
Okay.
All right. At any moment throughout this live stream, who wants to hear these boys sing?
Oh.
I'm sure you've learned a thing or two on the road, according to that photo.
Yeah.
All right, boys, come on up here. Come on up here. Let's get you first before the choir backs you up. We're just going to get you to say hittheroadusa.com in your best voices. Just silence, everyone, silence. And 3, 2, 1, take it away.
Hit the road, USA.
Oh, take it home.
All
right, let's do it all together now, including the choir. Step in there, boys. Step in there. Let's join the choir one more time. If you want to pre-sale, if you want to pre-order your Hit the Road USA DVD, you just have to head to...
Hit the Road USA.
Nice work. Boys, come take a seat. I love that.
Thank you.
Nice work. And choir, if maybe you want to take a little bit back there, and every time you hear, that's the challenge. One more time, give them a round of applause. Woo! I like how into that you were, Joe. Your neck started to, like, shake. You're like, oh.
Wait, what was it again? Yeah. Can we just do it whenever?
Yeah. Hittheroadusa.com. Oh, the challenge issued.
What was it?
We just have to go to, it's a website. It's called Choir.
Hit the Road USA.com.
Oh, yes, that is lovely.
That's going to be in my head now for the rest of the day. Stuck
now,
in my head.
Boys, let's talk about the road trip. This is why we're here. It is your rap party. Is it the same as last year? What can we expect? What's different?
It's different. Casper's grown taller since the last one.
He has indeed. Yeah. Seriously, stand up. The last time we saw each other, I could hug and put my chin on your... Now it's like, I have to get my tippy toes.
I'm trying to play I'm trying to play basketball. Oh, what happened? Basically, I think my body represents the change...
All that is man.
No, it represents Hit the Road. So last year it was really cool and stuff, but this year it's bigger.
Ah,
does that make sense?
See
so, yeah.
What he did here.
Everything about me.
Bigger and smellier.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, for example, last year we kind of, when we did our announcement, it was over webcam type thing. And now look at that. We have a whole studio. Like everything's just increased.
You've got a choir.
You've got all of YouTube Space LA as well.
So
at your beckham.
I think that's because of the amazing support that everyone gave it last year. It was an amazing success. And we're just so thankful. So thank you all. Thank you all.
Yeah.
And as well, it's different this year because we were allowed our phones as well.
Oh.
We were actually allowed technology this time, which was good.
So really?
So we could...
How did that change everything?
Oh, it means we've got so many Instagrams stored up for the end of the year. Or we can't put them out yet, but as soon as the release date comes out...
Oh, can't wait to
flooded.
See it. What about the challenges? Are the challenges the same? What kind of challenges did you come up against?
We no longer needed to make money for the trip. It became more about challenges and winning.
So you always put your giant fingers near my face. Creeps me out. Carry on.
So they were also way bigger and more scary.
Yeah, they were.
Can you tell us a little bit about it? Can you maybe, without giving too much away, obviously, what are some of the challenges you did?
I mean, you saw something there.
Yeah.
Earlier.
A little choir situation.
Yes. And then a bunch of, I don't want to give too much away, but maybe we can talk about the...
Well, we went to Houston. So I'm guessing
anyone from Houston?
I'm pretty much guessing you can all tell what we did in Houston. Houston's famous for like one thing, other than that's where Beyonce was born, apparently.
Okay.
But, you know, is that true?
Oh,
yeah, that's true.
You guys
we also
cowboys.
Went to Arizona,
yeah.
where this photo was taken.
Actually, I knew all about this particular part because we actually have some exclusive footage. You boys don't know that we have this, but feast your eyes on this. The boys become cowboys.
Cowboys are romantic because we've seen them on the big screen throughout our lives.
Yeah, they've got that sort of tough exterior. With every tough exterior, you know, there's a soft interior. You know, they're tough, they get their job done, they're rugged. But then at the end of the day, they go home, they hang up their hat and boots and whatever.
And you don't have cowboys, really, where we're from. Horses appreciate the connection I give them when I show them love.
I've discovered that horses don't smell as great as they look. We're kind of used to it now, but it's ponging, you know? Horses smell a little bit like wet dog. I think I'm not afraid of getting hurt. Like I'm good.
You
at
can't
like
even go on roller
stuff.
Coasters.
Yeah, no, you don't get hurt. I'm not afraid of like falling off a horse or like, you know, taking them for the team or like doing stuff that's really physical. I don't mind doing that, but I've just got the height disadvantage. I'm not very tall. So I don't know if that'll come into play. Yeah, see, I'm doing this whole interview on tiptoes. You didn't realise.
Okay, so we got a little bit of a sneak peek into some of the challenges.
That's some behind the scenes.
Yeah, some BTS, if you will. Hey, I know that finishing the road trip, coming through the doors, it is the wrap party, and I know you probably think the challenges are over for this year, but I say keep the challenge party going, and what better way to do that than through cowboy charades?
Oh!
So the way this is going to work, boys, there are five audience members that have been hand-chosen to come up here. Oh, they're going to select a cowboy-themed charade to act out to you from an Uncle Sam hat. Both of you have your faces either side. When you know the answer, you buzz in by raising your face. Here's the clincher. You only have 30 seconds with said charader. Yeah?
Right.
All right. Now that that's all set up, can I have a massive round of applause for our first charader? Come on up. Come on up. Hello, my dear. What is your name?
Karina.
Karina. Welcome, Karina. All right. I'll hold the hat. You just take a little dip in there, Karina, and tell me what you've got. Let's see it together. Don't show anyone. Don't show anyone. Number one. Ooh, good luck with that. All right. So, Karina, you have 30 seconds. Oh, by the way, Karina, that's Joe and Caspar. Joe and Caspar, and Karina. All right. Now that we got that out of the way. Karina. Oh, that's nice. Oh. What's going to happen, Karina? Just here, you are going to charade the best you can, obviously, without talking. Act out the title of that without talking, and the boys have to buzz in 30 seconds. Now, I'm going to keep time. I'm going to keep time. Have a think about it. Have a quick think. Have a quick think. Let me set this up. All right, boys. You ready?
Yeah. We're ready.
Yeah.
Okay. Ready. Karina, your time starts. Let me take that off you. Now, go.
One word. Wait, how many words?
Lion King.
Ooh. No, how many words? One.
One word. Three, four, five. Yeah.
Yep. Six words?
The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Ooh. Yeah. Cowboy Rider.
Brokeback Mountain.
Tom, thumbs down.
Thumbs up. Good.
No. 9 seconds.
Good. The good, the bad, the ugly.
Oh. Yes. Yes. That is in fact it. In 26 seconds, you got a nice work, Karina. Good stuff.
Can we go to the video? Can we go to the video referee? Did he buzz?
Did he buzz? I did.
Yeah, okay. The buzzers aren't quite working. I need to keep an eye on that as well. Let's give Karina a massive round of applause. I don't know how you got that. That was well done.
Really good.
Can I get the second guest up on stage? Please give her a round of applause. Keep that going.
Hello.
What's your name, my dear?
Carolina.
Hey, Carolina.
Carolina. Right.
Carolina. By the way, the boys, Carolina.
Sweet Carolina.
All right, draw through the hat. Nice work. Let's see. Oh, number five. Yeah, I know. Oh, gosh. All right. Remember, you've got 30 seconds. Boys, remember, you need to buzz in. My hat goes down here. Reset on the timer. And your time starts now. Go for it.
Ooh. How many words? Two.
Don't talk.
Buzz, is it?
Walk the line.
I walk the line.
Incorrect. No. Keep going.
Howdy, partner.
Caspar. Ooh, close. Caroline. Nice. Keep going. Oh, it's so.
Can you give us something else?
I lick.
Opening.
That's kind of. I don't know what I'm doing.
That's okay. Right.
28 seconds. Time.
Forrest Gump.
The answer was, in fact, lickety-split.
Oh, no.
Lickety-split. Let's give Carolina a massive round of applause.
Thank you.
No points.
Thank you so much.
No points. Let's get the third guest up.
High five.
Keep that applause. That's
split.
Lovely.
It sounds like a dessert.
Ah, that's the prize. All right, next guest up. Give her a round of applause as she makes her way up. What is your name, my dear?
Jacinda.
Hey, Jacinda.
Hello.
Remember 30 seconds. Put your hand in the hat. Take what you can. Let's see what we got. Number three. Oh, that's going to be fun. That's actually a good one. I like that one a lot. 30 seconds. Remember this. I'll take that off you. Nice work, Jacinda. Reset. Your time starts now.
Cowboy.
Buzz
rodeo.
In. Buzz in.
Oh.
Two words.
Buzz in. Joe.
The rodeo.
Oh, close.
Two words. Oh, This Joe. Ain't a rodeo. This ain't my first rodeo.
No, two words.
20 seconds. You got 10 seconds left. Brr,
good Joe. Rodeo. Brr, bad rodeo.
It's one half. Fun it's one rodeo. 5 seconds. Brr. Casper.
Hello. Food rodeo.
Time. Oh.
We're not great at this,
oh,
are we?
That was
what
close.
Is it? What is it?
You got the first one. Rodeo clown.
I don't know. I
rodeo
don't
clown.
Oh my
no
gosh.
Point. So far, sorry, Casper's the only wrong. One on one point. Not doing so well here, guys. I know you've been on a 2-week road trip. Can we get another round of applause for our second last guest? Come on up, come on up, come on up. What is your name, my dear?
I love your shirt.
Evelyn, thank you.
Hey, Evelyn. What does it say? If you're reading this, I'm still single. Oh, that's good. Timely. All right. Take that one out of there. Number four. Whoa. Okay, number four. I reckon start off with how many words there are with that one, because that's a huge one. All right, boys. God. It's a common saying. That's the only clue I'm going to give you. It's a common saying. Here we go, Evelyn. Your time starts now.
How many words?
Horn. Get back
six.
On the horse.
Get back on the horse.
Close.
Lawnmower. That's the lawnmower.
Okay, how many words?
It's a shopping cart.
Six.
Six.
When you're really trying at life.
Horns.
10 seconds.
Grab life by
grab
the horns.
Life.
Joe.
When life give you lemons. No, that's the one, isn't it?
4 seconds.
Grab life by the horns.
Oh, that's
horny.
By a technicality, I'm going to give that to Casper. That's 2 points to Casper.
What
it was, in fact, grab the bull by the horns.
I didn't know we were allowed to say that.
All right, do we have one more? One more. Nice work, Evelyn. Good stuff. Come on up. Last one. Give a round of applause. Two to Casper, one, none to Joe. All right, what's your name, my dear?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, welcome, Elizabeth. Hello. That's the last one in there. Last one in there. Number two. All right, you get that? Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at them, look at them, look at them, look at me, look at me, look at me. All good? All right. 30 seconds.
You just hypnotized her.
Yeah. All right, here we go. You ready? In 3, 2, 1, time starts now.
Two words.
Toy Story.
First word. L.
LA. Ooh.
LA. LA Confidential.
LA is a...
It's a city. State. LA City. LA City.
City of Angels.
City...
Think Cowboy.
LAPD.
Think Cowboy.
Licking.
LA Licking.
10 seconds.
LA Massage.
When you put oil in your hair, you...
LA Massage.
Grease Lightning.
LA Slickers.
3, 2, 1. Stop time. Oh.
LA Clippers.
Boys, LA. I thought you'd learn about cowboys.
We were cowboys, just didn't watch it.
That is in fact. In.
Angels.
City Slicker.
Oh.
I said LA Slickers.
That's all right. Yeah.
Sorry.
LA City.
We're not very smart.
That's all right. Let's give him one more round of applause. That hat is for you, my dear. Congratulations. And a little prize for our first game.
Yeah.
Casper, congratulations. You're now officially
I need to take a
American
Snapchat of this.
Cowboy.
Snapchat? Oh,
yeah, go for it. Go
guys,
for it. Please take photos.
And stuff, so if you're here, you can use it.
Yeah. Hey, while they Snapchat...
Hello, Snapchat. We're live still. Ooh, Sean Craig Rizzi.
Yes.
Look at my Instagram.
All right. I said before that we have clips... of the cowboy. We do have another cheeky one. For the ladies in the audience and watching at home, just a little word of warning. One of these boys doesn't have a top on. Let's take a look at this.
Wonder who that is.
You've got to have thick skin to be a cowboy. In more ways than one. You've got to be tough, but you've also got to wear in your boots.
I don't understand why cowboys wear such... Oh, sorry.
I've lost all the skin on my heel, on my ankles from these boots.
Do you not get socks?
Yeah, I'm wearing socks.
What kind of socks?
Just normal, standard...
No, I got them to get me special cowboy socks.
You got special cowboy socks? Get out.
Yeah.
What?
You don't have them up there?
I didn't get special cowboy socks.
Oh my gosh.
Another good thing about being a cowboy.
I think it's weird how cowboys wear such heavy clothing, even though it's so hot.
I feel like,
you know,
we're not sunburned. Got to be thick, rugged clothes, because at the end of the day, you're wrestling cows to the ground, you're riding horses around, you're like,
I'm not, I'm just sitting in the shade like, half the time.
Yeah, you're just lounging around by the pool.
Yeehaw!
That's classic a real banter slapper. Right there.
Yeah. Now, boys, particularly you, Joe, things got pretty crazy. In fact, you might say they got a little Nuts. I heard an interesting story about you while you were waiting for sunset on a horse.
Oh, yeah, I'm still recovering.
Yeah, tell us all about that.
So basically, I've never ridden a horse before in my life, right? And we went to this ranch, and like, yeah, just jump on it. The biggest horse I've ever seen. Like, it wasn't even a horse. It was more a dinosaur than a horse, right? I thought, okay, no helmet, just jump straight on. Health and safety, where, I don't know. Jumped on this horse, and they said, they didn't tell me that you've got to put 60% of your body weight into the stirrups.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's not a lot of body weight, but all my body weight was going into the saddle, hard. Because Casper's horse just bolted off, and my horse wanted to catch up because it was dinner time. And so I was there, literally like that, the whole way down. So, ow, ah, no, no, stop, stop. And yeah, one still hasn't, one, you know, I'm still not fully recovered.
We call that in Australia nuts in your guts.
That is, yeah, literally
right
what
in
was.
Your stomach.
Yeah, it right in the tummy.
Almost right. Like you've eaten it.
So we got to, I have to definitely remind everyone playing at home and you guys that we can, in fact, pre-order our Hit the Road USA DVD. You go to the website. Here we go, choir. You ready? Go to the website. Choir.
HitTheRoadUSA.com.
Oh, let's give you a round of applause. That's so nice. It's nice every time. Nice every time. Now, also to help pre-sales, because I noticed you did come in with some cheerleaders as well, and I am not missing an opportunity to have two cheerleaders next to me. So can I please have two cheerleaders up on the stage? Let's give these guys a round of applause. Two representatives from the new 2016 LA Rams team. Welcome, ladies. What is your name, my dear?
Jennifer.
Hey, Jennifer. And your name?
Melissa.
Jennifer and Melissa, welcome. Girls, I wonder, in order to help the pre-sales, much like the choir, if we could, on the spot, come up with maybe a cheer using hashtag HitTheRoadUSA. Do you think that's possible? Oh, absolutely. Look at the confidence. Look at the confidence. LA Rams, baby. All right, let's try it out. Here we go, and take it away. Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh. Oh.
Hashtag hit the road, USA.
Oh. Oh my gosh. Oh,
that was so pretty.
All my dreams are coming true.
You guys want to see the boys do the cheerlead as well?
Oh.
A little stitch up.
Oh,
obviously, because I'm sure that you learnt a little thing, a thing or two on the road. So what I'll get you to do, Casper, come in the middle here, Joe on the end, and feel free, studio audience, if you learnt the little choreography, just then play along. But let's do this one more time. Remember, you're finishing up. Hashtag hit the road USA. All right? And in 3, 2, 1, take it away.
We got it.
Lovi.
Nice work, fellas. Nice work, girls. I think we might leave it to the professionals on the next time we see that. Let's give Joe and Caspar a round of applause. Give the girls a round of applause. Nice work. Hey, girls, are you keen to stick around? And every time, obviously, you hear hashtag hit the road USA, we'll get you to do the cheer. Is that cool? Excellent. One more time. Give it a round of applause.
I was so worried I was going to punch someone in the face by accident. Then.
All right, so I did say before that for you guys live streaming and for you guys in the audience, it's time for some Q&A. We're going to offer at least 5 in the studio audience to come up and ask a question personally. And for you guys at home, make sure that you keep sending in your questions at hashtag hit the road USA. Lovely. Nice work. We will come to you very soon and I will try to ask as many questions as possible. So, first things first, studio audience, who's the first person we've got here? Let's give it a round of applause. First question for the boys. What's your name, my dear?
Hi, my name is Barbara.
Hey, Barbara.
Hey, Barbara.
What's your question for the boys?
What was your favorite place to visit while you were in the US?
I think my favorite place, other than LA, obviously, I really, really liked New Orleans, like in particular the French Quarter of New Orleans. That was really, really like interesting. It was really cool.
Yeah, okay. I was going to say New Orleans. I'm not just trying to copy him. It was beautiful. And we met some lovely people there.
Yeah, but it was humid.
What was beautiful humid. About it? What was beautiful? I
mean, we went to the French Quarter. That yeah. was, it was just, there was so much history there. Yeah.
For those French. Of us that have never been to said French Quarter, what's it like? What's the...
It's like,
is there just a bunch of French people with quarters? I don't know.
But they're all American now.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very like, it just feels old, you know? Like the architecture is like, it's all like old, ornate buildings.
Yeah.
And lots of like crazy people running around. It's yeah. really cool.
Does that answer your question, Barbara?
Yeah.
Nice work. Let's give Barbara a round of applause. All right. Who have we got here? What's your name, my dear?
Hello, I'm Jasmine.
Hi, Jasmine. Jasmine.
Hello. My question is, what was the funniest moment on set?
For me, there's a particular part where, because during this whole trip, we've done a few eating challenges, big eating challenges as well. And Casper's stomach got a bit sensitive after the first one. You struggled, didn't you? So
what's this reaction? What are you trying to hide? What's going on?
I just don't think you should be talking about it.
Let's just say we had to stop on the freeway to let him run across the freeway, which is quite dangerous, isn't it? That's pretty dangerous.
Yeah, generally.
Yeah. To relieve himself, you know?
Oh!
But did he make it? You'll find out. You know? Cliffhanger.
Disgusting. Awesome, nice work. Thanks. Give her a round of applause.
Spoiler.
My favorite part of the trip.
Yeah. He just did you. Hey, what's your name?
Hi, my name is Caitlin.
Hi, hello. Caitlin.
My question is, what was your favorite part of filming Hit the Road USA?
The fact that we had the same crew from last year just made it so easy to jump right back into yeah. it. Because we're a bit shy with new people. We're used to filming mostly on our own and with a yeah. tripod. So having actual physical people there is great when you know them and you trust them and you love them. Like, they're the funniest people.
Yeah. I think my favorite part, I think, was being on that ranch for like a few days. I completely forgot I was a YouTuber. By the end of it, I genuinely thought I was a cowboy. And I was like, I'm not coming home, I'm staying yeah. here.
Minus your manhood.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, I know.
Nice work. Let's give her a round of applause. Great question. And who do we have here? What's your name?
Hi, my name is Shannon.
Hello.
Hi. So my question is, what's the craziest thing that happened while on the road?
Other than Casper having that near mishap on the freeway.
It's up there.
I think... one of the eating challenges in particular, I think the first one that you'll see in the film, was one of the craziest things. I've never dreaded something during filming so much. They were telling me about it all day. And I was just like, I really don't want to do this. And I kept saying, do I have to do this? Yeah. And it turns out I did. And I've never been so scared.
It's kind of like what we did was almost poisoning ourselves.
Yeah.
So. Oh,
we put our bodies on the line on this one. Yeah. I've still got bruises everywhere. Yeah, I'm not going to get them out.
I thought you were going to say scars, bruises.
I've got bruises everywhere. I can't. That thing is, that's not the one I'm on about. There's ones worse than that. But yeah, that wasn't fun.
Awesome, nice question. Well done. Give it a round of applause.
Thank you.
And last one, lucky last question. Hey, my dear, what's your name?
Hi, my name is Jimena, and my question is, what other places would you have liked to visit?
Ooh, good question.
I would like to go to. I would have liked to have gone to Memphis, in Tennessee.
Oh, yeah, right. That, why?
I don't know. It just sounds cool. I've always wanted to say I've been to Memphis. Yeah, you know? Done that.
And Casper.
Washington would be cool to visit. See where all the
yeah, the like DC or the state.
Yeah. The DC.
Yeah.
DC.
Where's the Washington, place? DC? Where's the place with the faces carved into the rock? Mount Rushmore.
I'm Australian.
Mount Rushmore.
Mount Rushmore.
Where's that though? North Dakota. Knew it.
Thanks, guys. Awesome. Let's give the ladies a massive round of applause. Great questions. Yeah. Great questions. And now I'm being told we're going to our online questions. You guys have been tweeting your face off, which is awesome. Make sure that you use the hashtag #HitTheRoadUSA. We're going to go to the first question from online. If you just look to the screen below, guys, this one comes from @ChloeHood16. She asks, if you could change your name to anything, what would it be? Love from Chloe and Tricia in Australia. Oh,
that's nice.
Right on you, guys.
I would change mine to Jemima.
Okay, a girl's name? Yep.
Well, before I was born, my parents thought I might be a girl.
Oh, that's
and then,
right.
If I was born a girl, I was going to be called Jemima.
Yeah.
So just keep my parents happy, really.
Yeah, okay, that's nice. Yeah, that's good. Casper?
Neil.
Neil. Neil.
Neil.
The strongest man in the universe, Neil. any reason? Just...
Neil.
All right. I hope that answers your questions, guys. Let's go to the next one. This is from Jess Meyer Smith. Casper, why are you wearing flip-flops? Do you own another pair of shoes?
He actually doesn't.
No, when I'm in a warm climate, I like to keep my feet fresh and
ventilated.
Because when I was younger, I played hockey and I was the goalkeeper, obviously, because I couldn't play any other position. Not that goalkeepers are bad. They're great. I am a true testament of that, hopefully. But I have some like big injuries that have never gone away. But if I keep ventilating them, hopefully one day they'll go away.
Yeah,
he is. He's ventilating. They're growing. They don't stop. Doesn't stop growing.
The air is making him grow.
He's reaching the edge of the stage. Watch out.
It's lucky the question wasn't why are you wearing thongs. We call flip flops thongs in Australia, which means a completely different thing here.
But you should say
I don't know how you would have seen that.
But you should say that.
Yeah. Oh.
It's laundry day, all right.
Yeah. Awesome. Let's go to our next. A little close up.
What are those? Don't put them near me.
Let's go to our next question online. This one comes in from Ellie Sarah 5. How's your sunburn, Joe?
Well, do you know what? That's how it is. It's turned to tan now.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah.
One of the final challenges that we did involved us being pretty much naked,
one girl was like, "Woo!"
But there was a nice breeze coming. There was a nice breeze swirling around, you
yeah,
know.
Yeah.
So I thought, "I'm fine."
Yeah.
I forgot to put sun cream on.
Oh dear!
Careful, sun's dangerous.
It is. No it such is thing as a healthy tan. We say
but it's good. I haven't started peeling yet. That'll be all over Snapchat.
Yeah.
That's Joe. All one word. Follow me.
I've been thinking a lot about starting a sun cream company.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're just patenting that now, just laying it down.
So if anyone else thinks that's a good idea, don't do it.
Laying down the foundations. Oh,
the first YouTuber sun cream.
Yeah, okay. Could work,
We've done books, you know?
Yeah. Branching out, entrepreneur. All right, let's go to the next one. This one is from Annabelle's XX, who says, do you miss living together? If you do, what do you miss about living with the other person? That's a two-part question. I like that.
Yeah.
I miss...
Do you miss it?
Yeah. Okay. I miss coming back, and we used to always play FIFA. Do you guys? Yeah. I don't know if you guys have FIFA. Hey, you do? Yeah, nice, sweet. Yeah, we used to play FIFA too much, which almost affected
no
what
such
we
thing.
Do. Yeah.
No such thing.
But yeah, we have less games of FIFA, I guess.
Yeah. But we play online now sometimes when we have time.
Yeah.
He's scared of playing me.
Yeah.
Do you miss each other?
Yeah, yeah. And I miss like the amount of like just laughter that I get to have when I've got Joe living with me. But at least I still feel like I live with him because we're spending so much time together.
So much time
stuff.
On the road.
We're basically now stuck with each other until Christmas.
Oh really?
And even after Christmas.
And even after Christmas.
Holiday.
Yeah.
There you go. All right. And let's go one more question. This one comes from Dr. Time Lady. Have you ever considered adopting a pet together?
No, but we did consider adopting Ollie at one point. We thought, bless him, he needs help.
Does he know about this?
No, he didn't. That was the issue we had.
What does he need help with? Toilet training?
We found out he was over 18, so you can't adopt him.
Yeah. Oh. And he still isn't toilet trained, you're right.
So once he is of age, you're still seriously thinking about it.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Let's give the our live streamers a massive round of applause. It is now time. We are going to do some rapid-fire call-and-response questions. So using your paddles in the audience, what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you the question first. You tell me. Who you think it is out of the boys, and then the boys will use their paddles to confirm what the answer is. All right, studio audience, are you ready? Good, good. I'm glad you made some noise. All right, so, first question. Who takes longer in the shower?
Very mixed.
Oh, all right. Majority seems to look like Casper. Oh, no, they're changing their mind. It's gone to Joe.
Oh,
it's gone to... There was a quick change of mind there. And boys, what is the answer?
The answer is...
Me.
Joe.
Me.
Ah, Nice. Good work, studio audience. Good stuff. Good stuff. Next question, coming off our last conversation, who's got longer toes? Yeah, it's pretty simple. You can even tell.
There's not one paddle of me up.
Just to confirm, yeah, nice, love it. All right, nice work, studio audience. Two for two. Who has the hairiest legs? Who has hairier legs than the other?
Ooh, controversial. Oh, wait.
Okay, we've gone Joe.
Well, the answer, it's me.
You guys are so good.
You guys are on board. You are hardcore fans. I like this. Who's the better driver? That is unanimous. Oh, well. That is unanimous. Not one Caspar.
There's one over there. Oh, no, it's changed.
I'm going to have a trouble getting insurance one day because of this big joke that Joe's
created. Right? Yeah, we've seen your shows. You're not driving our cars. And the answer, of course, is...
Wait, hang on.
Yeah, maybe both of them.
Yeah. Okay.
We need to decide who is. Because last time we met in October, you didn't even have your license, did you?
Did you not see him driving today?
Yeah.
He reversed, he parked it, then he went back again, he revved it. He doesn't know what he's doing. I think he's broke that car. It's broken.
If you had to choose between the two of you, in all honesty, who's the better driver?
In smoothness, Joe, I think I could be faster, but we could give it to Joe.
If you want to get somewhere, if you want to actually get somewhere and get there safely, right. Me, if you want to potentially get there... And risk it, go with Caspar.
It's more fun, though.
You will get there quicker. If you make it, you'll get there quicker.
Fast is more fun. All right, we're going to leave that as a decider. Who's on their phone the most? Who's on their phone the most?
Wow.
Okay. Oh, it's split.
Can I just point out, Caspar was on his phone a minute ago, like during this actual thing.
All right, we're going to lock in Caspar. And the answer, of course, is... Yeah, straight away. All right, nice work, team. Nice work. Two more questions. Stay on board. For you guys playing at home, who's kissed more girls? Ooh.
Yeah.
Somebody else.
Mom.
Oh, it's a 50-50 spread. Oh, no. Now check. Oh, both battles have gone up.
Who's kissed more girls?
Both battles have gone up. Boys, what is the answer to this question?
I guess it's probably you, isn't it? It is probably
you. I don't want to boast.
Yeah. only by 2.5. He's in front of me by 2.5.
By 2.5? Yeah, what do you mean half?
I don't know. It was a really odd situation.
Let's not go there. Let's keep it PG. All right, last question. Here's one for you. Little exclusive. Who's got a secret tattoo?
Ooh.
Ooh, the conversations are being had, right? It's like, it's disgusting.
Well, like I said, it was a crazy road trip.
Some people aren't even putting their paddle up. I'm not even taking a risk, they say. I don't even know. Interesting. What is the answer to this one, boys?
We'll just do this. Yeah, so
interesting. All right.
Can I say that? It was so unfair because he had just Joe tattooed. That's three letters. I had to have Caspar. On my arse.
Cass and
Pa. Yeah.
Yeah,
Cass
so you had two cheeks.
So mine cost more, and it was more painful, because more letters.
All right, let's give these guys a massive round of applause. Nice for playing. Rapid fire. Call and response. Now, boys, while you were on the trip, 2 weeks, did you miss anyone from home? Did you miss home?
No.
Not at all.
Because we were allowed our phones this time, so it's kind of like... Just, you know,
you could catch up. You could stay in touch. Yeah. Okay. Well, we organized a little something special for your rap party because no rap party goes off without a hitch, without a little bit of nice sentiment and emotion. So feast your eyes on the screen, either here or in front of you, and you guys check this out. Some messages from home.
Can I just say I actually did miss everyone? Sorry.
I'm proud of myself.
Joe and Caspar. Jasper, hit the road, Jasper, and don't you come back no more. Well, you can come back. Go on, you can come back only if you make a success of your second movie. Only joking. Congratulations, lads, on another movie. Wow. I even got a movie, not alone two. Stop hugging all the movies.
Hey Joe and Caspar, I heard you are doing Hit the Road USA and doing a new movie. I am so super excited for it. I can't wait to see it. I hope you have a great time out there. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Hi Joe, hi Casper, congratulations on Hit the Road USA. Your last Hit the Road was hilarious, so we can't wait to see what you boys are getting up to in this one. And we'll see you soon, bye!
Hello Joe and Caspar, you fantastic little duo. Just wanted to say congratulations on Hit the Road USA, I cannot wait to see it.
Congratulations Joe and Caspar on Hit the Road USA, like I cannot wait to find out and see which ridiculously stupid situations you've got each other into. Good luck, boys. I will see you soon. I'm so excited.
Hi, guys, and congratulations on Hit the Road. I cannot wait to see it. You guys are absolutely smashing it. Next time, take me with you.
Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
I'm all ready. So, Joe, Casper, legends, good friends of ours, massive, massive well done for Jonathan. Tell
your
them what they're doing well.
Your second film, your second movie. We can't wait to see it. Congratulations. I hope you're having tons of fun filming it, and we look forward to seeing you very
soon. And you went to NASA. I hate you both. We will see you soon. Big love, boys. Well done.
Hi, boys. I am so, so excited for Joe and Caspar Hit the Road USA. I feel like it's going to be bigger, better, even more ridiculous, and I can't wait to see what weird situations you both get yourself into. I don't know how you even survive these things. Love you both. Bye!
Oh, how nice is that? A little message from mine.
Bless them.
Huh? Nice to see you, sister.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm actually just being told, how's this? The pre-sales are doing so well right now that the website I gave you, choir. is actually struggling with such high demand that there is a link on your screen for those of you that are live streaming. Go there for your pre-sales because apparently there's such high demand, it's shit itself. So let's move on, guys. I want to ask you, Director Brian, because I know last time we spoke, Director Brian was pretty mean in the last road trip. Yeah. How was he this time?
Oh, he was worse. We love him to bits. But he put us in some tricky situations.
Okay, so he upped it a notch. He took it to the next level.
Oh, he's crazy. We were put in confined spaces.
Oh.
We ended up getting injured.
Oh.
But he's the best. So
this time we do get along with him, but he's just gone a little bit.
I mean,
power crazy.
More about we're like, it's like a teacher you're scared of.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're nice to them, and like right now he'll probably watch this. We have to be nice to him.
No, the thing is, it's like one of those teachers that everyone hears about who's really mean, but then he's your tutor, he's like in charge of your class.
Sure.
And he turns out to be the biggest legend ever.
Well, yeah, he's responsible for how well you do.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. Exactly, yeah.
Well, it's interesting you say that because he also left you a little sweet message.
Oh, no.
Put your eyes on this.
Hey guys, how you doing? I'm back in London now, but having spent the last 2 weeks with you on Hit the Road USA, Hit the Road 2, we've had a fantastic time together. I've got a couple of memories though. My favourite two memories are firstly winning $100 from you, Joe, playing Paul, and there's actually picture evidence of that, which Jeffrey can show. And the second memory is when we penned the two of you up in a sort of metal pen that's normally used for steer. And I'm not going to give away what happened, but you were like trembling, the two of you, and when people buy the DVD or see the film, they'll see why I got so much pleasure out of it. But seriously, guys, have a good night. Good luck with the DVD. And I miss you already.
Oh. Thanks, Brian.
How was that sign-off at the very, I miss you already?
Yeah, that's what it says on camera.
What was the $100?
Oh, so I was feeling cocky. I was in cowboy mode. So I was like, yeah, I'm the biggest cowboy around here.
I think I beat him just before.
Yeah, Casper beat Brian in pool. And I say, if Casper can beat Brian, then I can beat Brian. So I say, oh, I'll put $100 on it.
Sure.
What a great idea, Joe.
Done, just like that.
He thrashed me, yeah.
He was hustling, so he obviously pretended to be bad first.
Do you think Brian will ever give you the opportunity to double or nothing?
Do you know what I actually said? That's double or nothing, right? And he's like, nah, I'm all right. I'm kidding.
Yeah, he's got himself
$100.
Yeah.
And then he tried to play me at table tennis
and
said, I'll play you for $100. I was just like, no way.
Not a chance. Who's better out of table tennis, the two of you?
Oh, out of me and Casper?
Yeah.
I'm terrible at all racket sports. Yeah, I'm so bad at racket sports.
Now, the guys that we've just seen, so we saw some messages from home. We saw a message from director Brian, but we're actually about to receive a call from home for you guys from a massive fan. In fact, we call them super fan. Let's come on in, super fan.
Hello, can you two hear me?
Yeah, hello. Hi.
Where the hell have you guys been for the last 2 weeks? I've been trying to phone you about 7 times. Right, I've heard anything. Oh, I sent you about 5 messages.
All right, Josh.
Where have you been?
Josh, calm down. All right? Take a breath. Take a breath. And just talk normally.
All right, where have you been for the last 2 weeks?
First of all, how did you manage to get past all the safety checks for this live stream?
The only way I could get hold of you, I saw there was a live stream happening, so I checked what was going on. I got hold of Brian, actually, he gave me the details, and I managed to get through, but other than that, I had no idea you two were alive. Bloody
hell. You look like you're about to laugh, Josh. he's gone.
We just wanted to say that we all miss you here from London, and we think you're doing a great job, and we can't wait for you to come back. And also, Caspar, put that hat back on. Okay. There's someone else here as well who wants to say hello.
Who?
Ooh. Hey!
And banana!
He's got a banana!
Right, sing for us, quick.
Just sing.
Oh, I'm here and I'm eating my banana, and I'm really nervous right now because this is the biggest thing I've ever done in my life.
Oh, I miss you, boys.
Bless him. Bless the cheed.
Go on, cheed. Put your mouth all in one. Go.
Finish the banana.
Get in there. And the skin. Get in there.
Bye, guys.
Thanks so much for calling in, Josh.
Cheers, we'll Josh. We'll be home one day.
Oh, there you go. Oh, he's there, he's not, he's there. Yep.
He's going to say, they're going to get naked on camera.
Yeah. Just anything to be in the background. How's it feel to see some of those guys back at home?
Yeah, it's good. It's good. Because they've been out here for a while.
Do they honestly have no idea where you've gone? Did you just disappear off the face of the earth?
We just kept it all secret,
Yeah, right. So they have no idea.
They'll worry about us, you know.
Yeah.
They'll try and get involved somehow.
It was good.
Yeah.
It's like a little holiday.
Again, I have to remind, for those of you that are playing at home, this is my job, this is my important job. The camera keeps changing. Make sure that you hit either the website choir.
Hit the road, USA.com.
And also use the hashtag. And if either of those don't work, make sure that you hit the website on the screen just below. There should be some details.
What do they get?
They get the pre-order, the DVD.
And they get their name in the...
And they get their name in the credits.
And
a jelly band, a numbered jelly band.
Can I just say, I've got number
got one
this
on.
Time.
You've
I've got one on. This is what it looked like. Get a close-up on that. Camera two. this is number one.
Number one. How did you get number one? Did you guys have to fight for that?
Yeah, because where's your number one from last year, Caspar?
So I mean I've lose things a lot.
Yeah.
I've lost my room key about 40 times, but luckily I have my ID, so they let me back in.
Yeah. Your ID? Oh, security at the door.
Yeah.
Right.
At night I can hear clawing on my door. I'm like, oh, it's Caspar again. Go on, scram.
Now, boys, your room key. We promised some big global announcements. The first one, of course, is that you can pre-order the DVD, but there's another massive announcement, another tour.
Yes. Yes, there is.
Was that Stewie?
I don't know. There is. There is a tour.
Yeah. Yes. Should
tell you more about the tour.
Yeah, please, tell us all about it.
Last year, we did the tour in Australia.
Correct. We had a ball.
With you. And... it was so much fun. It was like an immersive experience of hit the road heaven.
It was 6D, apparently.
It was
6D.
60?
Six dimensionals.
Yeah.
60 dimensions?
No.
6D. Like a 4D, 6D experience.
No, I have no idea what you're saying. I don't understand.
It was so much fun that we've decided to take it global.
Right. So this time, you guys are actually visiting somewhere you've never been before, is that correct?
Even places in our own country that we've never been before.
Yeah.
Like, so we're going to, shall we read them all out?
Yeah, go for it.
You echo me.
Okay. I got ya.
Sheffield City Hall.
Liverpool Empire.
Wolverhampton Civic Hall. Manchester 02 Apollo.
I feel like reading out the lottery numbers.
You're going very old English. Yeah. Richard.
Manchester 02 Apollo.
Newcastle City Hall.
Glasgow
Clyde. Auditorium.
London Eventum Emporium.
Enmore Theatre, Sydney.
We're going to Sydney. Oh, in Enmore Theatre, Sydney.
That's not a bad Australian accent.
QPAC.
We're going to QPAC in Concert Hall.
Adeline. Adelaide, sorry, I was joking.
We're going to the Barton in Adelaide. Who'd have thought it, eh? Truth.
Auckland.
We're going to New Zealand.
So the big announcement, guys, is in fact that these guys are traveling New Zealand, Australia, and of course the UK. And tickets are on sale tomorrow for the UK at 9 a.m. and, of course, 12 p.m., so noon for Australia and New Zealand. It's going to be awesome. Ooh. In fact, we do have a clip of you and I spending some time together in Australia. Let's take a look at that. It was mental.
Oh, throwback.
Yeah, throwback.
I'm with Caspar. Hello. And we are off on an adventure. We are off to Australia. I'm coming from Milan. Do your best impression of a didgeridoo. Oh my god. Caspar, you ready? Melbourne, let's go. Woo! G'day, we're here in Sydney.
Please welcome Caspar Lee and Joe.
Who are you here to see? It is incredible.
Joe and Caspar, would you marry me?
Yeah, it was such an incredible time. That was so good. That's what you can expect on the tour. So make sure you book your tickets tomorrow. As I said, 9 a.m. for the UK and 12 noon for Australia and New Zealand. What was your favorite part about Australia? What did you love?
The people.
Yeah.
We had a really cool security guy called Neil.
Yeah, that's right.
Remember
Neil.
Yeah. He did a thing to us.
Who did like a death grip?
Yeah, he has a death grip where he can touch you and you'll fall over.
Literally, quite literally. It was like a little claw and then you just hit the deck. He was serious security.
Also, I surprisingly liked Vegemite. I actually didn't mind it. I quite liked it.
Oh, that's right. You hated it, Caspar, didn't you?
I prefer Marmite.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that which is very, that's a big faux
it's
pas.
Controversial.
Yeah, Marmite is from New Zealand and we, yeah. Oh.
Is it from New Zealand?
Yeah.
New Zealand.
Yeah, I'm pretty, I can't confirm, I will not confirm nor deny, but I will say that as far as I know, yeah, Marmite is the Kiwi version.
That's a favorable yeast extract.
Yeah, yeah. Now, I'm actually being told, so let me ask you a little bit more about the road trip. We did speak a bit more, and I know that you don't want to give too much away, but if you could give dot points, what else were you doing on the road trip? So far we've covered a little bit of choir. We've covered a little bit of NASA.
Yeah.
What about some extreme fishing?
Oh, yeah. We did.
Yeah.
I think that was one of my highlights as well. Oh, my word.
What were we allowed to say? anything? Are we allowed?
Don't give too much away, obviously.
But there were some very scary things that came on our boat.
Interesting.
There's not just fish in the water, you know. There's
actually,
more than that.
Speaking of which, I know that you are like devastatingly scared of the water, Joe.
Yeah.
And there was one particular challenge that involved some floaties and maybe a revival system.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Actually, we have it back here. Have a look at this.
I saw that backstage. I thought it was an Xbox.
Yeah.
I got excited. I was like, we're going to get an Xbox.
Surprise, we gifted you an Xbox. No, it's in fact a little CPR dummy.
It's a headless person.
Is it true that both of you have had your mouth on this dummy?
Yeah.
But then we had plastic. I think we had plastic, hopefully, over it. Did we?
Did you have plastic over it?
I can't remember.
We had a mouth guard.
Maybe just kiss it now. Just kiss it. But there you go. Oh,
his breath still stinks.
Yeah. Who wants it?
Everyone's like, nah, like, all right.
I'm not really sure. Tell us a little bit about this. Tell us a little bit about this system.
I can show you how to do it.
Yeah, can you?
Do you want on Joe's lap, maybe?
Yeah, you go for it, mate.
On Joe's lap?
I will supervise.
How does this work?
Don't put it here. Yeah, do it on the floor.
All right, yeah. With head or without head?
There we go.
I've never said that sentence before.
Sorted. Now it's much more pretty.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yep. He's dead. He's dead.
Just so you know, that is not the way to do CPR.
He's dead.
Honestly, this is important information. Okay. So, you find a body. You first check if it's actually needing CPR, because you don't want to give CPR to someone who doesn't need it. Otherwise, you've got a case on your hands.
A little step. You find a body.
Touch his pulse.
Don't judge me. All right. I've only done this once.
Okay. Good.
And then what happens is, You touch his pulse and I call. I say, Joe, can you call 911?
Yes.
Wait, can I borrow your phone? What's your password for your phone?
Oh, I can't give you that because you're gonna see everything.
They're dying.
Okay, sorry.
But then what? What am I gonna?
Okay, 64.
I'll use mine.
Okay.
Hang on.
Okay, so check for pulse. Oh no, there's no pulse.
I've got no battery. Hang on. I'll just run and try and find someone for help.
Put your hands like this.
I got you.
Put your hands like this, like that. So she straighten up, go over the top, push, and don't worry about breaking his ribs.
I guess your password.
Don't worry about
yes.
What is it? Right, how do I get on Twitter?
You do 30 reps and you sing it to the song of Staying Alive. Staying alive. 30 times, and then every 30 you do 2 blows.
Yeah, but his head's not connected to his body. It's not going to work.
Oh, I saw some happen. They've come to life. Caspar just saved the life of a dummy. Do you really have to do ha?
Yeah, no, that's the rhythm. That's the rhythm.
That's ridiculous. Yeah. Let's give these guys a round of applause. While Joe's on Snapchat, Caspar's saving a life.
And that is why...
Snapchatting?
No. Oh, I should have.
Now, boys, we are actually about to receive another Skype call. I'm being told, because it's so early, we're going to Australia now to a good friend of mine, Scott Tweedy, who is a fellow prankster. Oh, is he asleep for real? Is he actually... Scott! Hey. Scott! He's a TV presenter and radio. Dude, are you there?
No.
Please welcome Scott Tweedy.
Hello!
Boys?
Ladies and gentlemen of the audience, Kayne Tremills, good to see you. I heard these screams before.
Hello, Australia.
Mate, what time is it there in Australia right now?
Oh, it's too early. It's like 6:14 a.m. The sun hasn't even risen. It's like, I'm just having my breakfast now. Actually, I've got like my Vegemite right here on the plate. You go, which I heard you boys don't actually mind as well. So we are so excited that you guys are coming down under, even though it's early in the morning. So many people are up right now watching you live. They've been Instagramming, tweeting me, Facebooking me, asking me to ask you questions. But first and foremost, I know John?
No, I think it was Joe.
I know that you've been to New Zealand, but
a cat hit the roof.
This classic Australian Wi-Fi.
Yeah. So yeah, Caspar, what about Caspar?
So Caspar, what have you heard about New Zealand?
Okay. I mean, Lord of the Rings. I heard they make my favorite, they make Marmite. Out of the two, I prefer Marmite to Vegemite, no offense.
Yep.
And I feel like the difference, Australia's like this, and New Zealand's like this. So they go down at the end of their sentences.
The inflection goes up and down. Yeah.
This is sweet ears, bro.
Yes.
Sweet ears, man.
Sweet ears, bro.
I'm very excited.
Oh,
I'm
going to get wit. Hey.
Hey, John. New Zealand, right? Why do you love New Zealand so much?
I don't. I went to New Zealand. Here we go. This is the story, right? I went to New Zealand back in 2011 with two of my mates in a camper van, like Katie, traveling around for 3 months. And I just had the best time. Just like it's the most beautiful country.
Where did you go? Because there's the North Island and the South Island.
I did it all. I went everywhere. Oh. I was all over the shop. Yeah, I loved it.
How long did it take you?
3 months.
Don't encourage him.
Yeah, don't encourage him.
It's a big story.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I get really excited. I could talk about this. How long have we left? We've got the show. I could talk about it for the rest of the show. I love it.
we'll give Scott some time and then I'll ask some more questions. Hey, Scott.
No, heaps of fans have been asking me questions for you guys. Right now, we're actually in a bit of a weird time with Prime Minister. We've got a hung parliament. So Brianna, 2001, wanted me to ask you, if you boys were Prime Minister, what would you make happen here in Australia?
Ooh. Hectic question.
Yeah.
What would you, in the time you spent with us in Australia, what would you change? What would you like to see more or less of?
I would make.
What would I like to see more of? I love Bondi Beach.
Yeah, I'd make it a law that every day, like at least one day, like maybe Wednesday, like the hump day of the week, you get to just go to the beach. It's a beach day.
Oh, beach, spend beach time hump the beach. Day. Oh.
Yeah.
Hump beach
that
day.
That should be a thing.
Yeah,
I Aussies would love that. We absolutely love that. And then India Martin won.
We're a little bit slow in Australia. Say again, Scott.
If you boys got a tattoo, what would you get it of?
Ooh,
well, no. I mean, I would get a J on one side of my bum and an E on the other side of my bum.
Oh, that's vile. That's grim. I don't get it.
You don't get it.
And last question, Scott. We're going to have to wrap you up there.
Sorry. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that.
It's got all a right. little hop.
Sheringle wanted to...
Oh, yeah, good. Every question. Say again for us, Scott.
Is Hit the Road Australia ever going to happen? That's from Sheringle.
Massive question.
I would love that to happen.
This was asked a lot last time, and I know that you both said that you would. If you could, where would you go?
I should probably go to Perth because I've actually had family in Perth.
Oh, do you?
I've never actually met.
I didn't know that.
That could be a nice little storyline.
Yeah,
there,
meet the family.
We're off to meet my family.
Yeah, bro. Do they thatch roofs?
No, they don't. They ride. Actually, ironically, they ride horses. Whoa. You love them.
I love them.
I would not be as.
The family would be so disappointed.
I'd love to go to the outback.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. Yep. The Northern Territory.
Oh, yeah. And Fraser Island.
Yeah.
That'd be fun. Yeah. They've wild dingoes there.
They got dingoes. They do indeed. They do indeed. All right. Well. Maybe if we do the pre-sales and we nail it today,
on,
maybe,
guys,
maybe Road Trip Oz could be a possibility.
Right. It's gonna go nuts. Everyone in Australia and New Zealand is so excited. So boys, we can't wait to see you here. We'll share a Tim Tam with you as well. So now until you're back down under where you belong. Cheers, boys.
Thank you so much, Scott, for joining us. Let's give Scott a round of applause.
What a legend.
All the way from Australia, we're now going to go to the UK from Capital FM radio station. We've got Roman Kemp. Give Roman a round of applause. Yay. Roman, are you there?
Robin.
He's not ready. He's not ready. I lied. Psych. In the meantime, though, if you were, because you guys actually got a fair bit of creative in the second one, didn't you? So I know that in the first one, you know, you had some ideas of where you wanted to go, but this time you got a little bit more creative with it.
Oh, yeah. We were calling all the shots.
Booking flights.
We were calling all the shots. We sorted it all out. We were the top.
We're the...
The top Timmies.
We knew exactly what was happening the whole time.
Interesting. Except took the power.
We can't actually say what happened, but it's we tried to take control.
Is that in the new DVD?
Yeah,
it actually is. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, let's try that again. We are coming to Roman Kemp from the UK. Capital FM. Roman, you there?
Is.
Hello, chaps. How are you?
Hello, mate. You all right?
Good to see you. You're looking good.
Thank you very
You're
much.
You're looking and, good.
Yes. So I'm actually on air right now. Like I'm live doing the radio
Capital.
Right now, talking to you guys. Yeah. So hello. Hello to the UK guys. You've both been on the show before. It's always good to have you here. But you've been doing your ting over in the States. But I do have to ask. You're looking very jolly together right now. But are you still mates? Really?
The UK press, huh?
Yeah. Yes, we are.
We cut straight to the gossip, Caspar. This is what we do.
Although, throughout filming,
although Joe, you're not really touching his. Yeah, you're kind of doing like the air high five hand.
That's the thing about radio. He can pretend that we're not actually touching, but we are.
there was a moment actually throughout filming where when we were on the ranch, I found a fun little game of throwing dried horse poo at Caspar. Whenever he's doing an interview, I just get a big old handful of it and just launch at him. It might be in the film, it might not be.
Was it ever wet or always dry?
Towards the end, I got really confident and started throwing wet ones. Yeah. But
the thing is, Roman, he had to touch the the horse poo with his bare hands as well. So it also had, you know, it was worse for you.
Pooey hands.
I was a cowboy. I was loving
it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, Caspar, last time you came on the show here, I hooked you up to a lie detector, like a legit lie detector. I had your mum ask the questions, right? Okay, so maybe even to get back at Joe for that, we could put Joe in the lie detector. If you could ask Joe, if Joe was hooked up to a lie detector, what would you ask him? You can ask two questions.
Good question, Roman. Good question.
Ooh.
Ooh.
What would we want to know? What's going on in Suggy's brain?
Yeah,
what has he done?
I'd want to know. This is, you see, there's so many things. I'm trying to think.
this is getting deep real quick. All right.
Was it really you who did that thing to my toilet that one time that I went away?
What thing?
Yeah,
I don't want to embarrass him right now, but there was one thing. And then also,
Joe, you look so nervous.
Two-part question.
You're not even on the lie detector yet, Joe.
and am I your favorite child?
Are you okay?
That's a tough question. That's a tough question. But no, guys, obviously, one thing that we have to talk about, the girls out in the States, right? Who did they go for? Did they like Caspar, or is it the Brit? Because the Brit charm works over there. I'm sorry, Caspar, but Joe must have been, you know.
Thing is, right, it does, but Casper's a lot more outgoing than me. If he wants someone's number, he will go and get it. He'll go right up to him.
You know,
I'm not sure that's the right thing to do though. Just walking up to someone being like, give me your number now.
No, but the thing is, they love it. They're like, here.
No, we actually, we have cheerleaders following us everywhere we go. Seriously, we have two cheerleaders. Where are they?
I get that every day. What, you don't have that?
No. It only started happening to us in the States. You have that every day?
Every day, dude.
Do
every day.
That's in the Capital FM contract. That's
oh
in the
my
Capital.
God. Yeah. That's in the contract. No, but dudes, it's been absolutely awesome talking to you. It's cool. I'm so happy for you guys, and I cannot wait to see the film. It's gonna be incredible.
You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it.
Well, thanks so much, Roman.
I'm gonna have to get back on air.
Yeah,
see
do it, mate. Do it. Thanks
Cheers,
so
Roman.
Much. Give Roman
bye
a bye. Massive round of applause.
See you in a minute.
Make bye. Some noise. Oh, there you go. Oh, we've seen some people, huh? We've been on a trip. We've been on our own little trip in here with the rap party. And sadly, boys, studio audience, live streamers, we are going to have to bring it to a close. It is, unfortunately, almost the end of the show, I know. But before, I did promise that you guys would hand sign this inflatable banana. So I'm going to give you
a couple of texters. It's not the first banana I've signed.
There you are. Some texters there. And I will do my job and remind you guys playing at home to get onto the website. You can pre-order your DVD. Make sure that you use the information on the screen or head to One More Time Choir.
Hit the
road, USA. Nice work. Let's give the choir a massive round of applause. Well done, team. Well done to everyone. All right, has that been signed? Hey, you want to throw it out to them? Who wants the banana? Who wants the banana?
I'm going to shut my eyes and
throw it. Just get in there. Just go. Oh, good catch. Oh, yeah. How are you going to decide who keeps that? Also, guys, the DVD is available on iTunes worldwide and Google Play. And remember, for the first lot of people that pre-order, you can get your name in the credits of the new DVD as well as a jelly band, a numbered jelly band. So make sure you get on top of that, boys. Should we finish the show like we always do with an awesome selfie of this audience?
Oh, yeah.
Let's get it done. I think I said a Tim Tam slam on it. No, no.
And I also wanted, I think we both want to say thank you to everyone in the production who put this all together and all you guys at home and here. Thank you so much.
Yeah, really absolutely. Absolutely. All right, boys, take your little selfie. And everyone in the background, say hello. Let's get the lights up.
Get in.
Oh, yeah. Get on in. Oh, here we go. One more thing, boys. We got you some all-American goodie bags. All-American goodie bags right here. There you are.
You did.
Oh, some all-American goodie bags in there. There's a tiara. Ooh, so that'll go well. There's that thing.
That's Christmas presents sorted this year.
That's that thing. Anyway, awesome, guys. Thank you so much for joining us. All the live streamers across the world.
Good afternoon,
good evening. Oh. Goodbye. Thank you so much to the live audience. My name is Kayne Tremills. This is Joe Sugg and Caspar Lee. We'll see you next time.
Cheers.
Peace out.
Bye. Yeah.